Please silence any devices, unwrap any candies, and quiet anything or anyone that might make noise. Please no photography or video recording of any kind. Thank you so much for joining us and enjoy the show.
Barefoot in England. You were always raised like a beast in the walls of Africa.
Do you not wear shoes, Beth?
Well, we don't in the town, but we do in the bush.
Is that where they keep the lions? Oh, Africa must be horrible.
But lions are beautiful, Becky, and so is the land. The skies are open and sunny, and the people are too. Come, look at the people here. Dark shapes under darker umbrellas, rushing about in the fog and the rain. In San Luis, where I come from, there'd be no hurry, no worries, everything in color.
We've got colors in England,
not like there. So the day my ship is due to sail, I went into hiding.
But you get in trouble.
You have to imagine it, Becky. A place worth the trouble. Drummers in the town square, open doorways, everyone singing. It's so beautiful, you risk anything to stay there. I did. I never wanted to leave.
Yeah. line, say goodbye. Love is calling, it is calling, an hour at most to keep the grass green there. Birds are singing, bells are ringing, yes, if you boast you're lost till you've been there. It's a cab from pretty London Bridge, since it cost worth the pilgrimage. It's calling you.
My mother was French.
After all those years married to her, you'd think I would have noticed a thing like that. But like it or not, my blood is English, and your future lies in England.
I've never even set foot before.
And will never, like you talk to me to peace.
Soon, my love, you must be going. Soon, my love, you must us, there's no knowing, still there's hope with every day.
I wish old John would cast one of her spells, so we never have to leave Africa behind.
Oh, so I know magic enough for that.
Rise your memories, bear them with you, learn. I'll share them with you.
home to London myself to fetch you home. Until then, whenever you have something to say to me, you must say it to Welsh Adam here with all your heart. If you do, I promise I will hear it.
Thank you.
Thank you. killed.
When white people stop buying slaves, we will stop selling them.
If she doesn't want to parlay, won't she let us continue on to Timbuktu?
But Ermengarde, you have to remember, 100 years ago, we're the ones who taught them how to.
Moko bara adam, moko fam.
Opo uno ewe ki abodo na ala uno, abodo dina ala uno, ha ye teoto, no dina ruwe nanda agwabi.
Are there no cities in your country? Is not one city like another? You must stay here until I say.
Is there nothing we can give her to change her mind?
The umbrella.
We'll meet here tomorrow morning and get started.
I keep the boy. He's my slave now. Tell your queen, Christian, these lands belong to me, the widow Zuma. If she returned to them, she must die. You are free now. Go.
I'll trade you. If you want bullets too, and powder, you'll have to let us go.
Allah Akbar, you are a beautiful people.
Down. These people live always in the sea, in boats. Once they write the country down,
sword or piece of scarlet or any cloth, you made it.
The English.
Hold out your hand.
Ah! Our Kareem!
He took it to Philippe. He does not cry out to the God of the Christians.
You were the one that his red coat. Will you give us food for it?
And carry this letter to the coast.
Come here before you see all the corporation to exploit the new trade capital is expected to establish.
She'll be richer than ever now. You have to deal with her very carefully. Or some other fool will get her and her money.
Sister!
She's smart. She's pretty.
What's an indigo with?
deception in it. Indigo is a color, silly. This color.
Oh, it's beautiful.
You may have it.
No, miss. No, believe it. It's sealant.
Oh, but please, I want you to.
Oh, miss. I never had another friend to give it to me before.
Unless it were a beating. I'll leave it here. And I'll visit it.
Oh, I'm so grateful. They're so kind. It's like it really was a princess.
We all thought you were some sort of princess when you first came here.
That's why I'm so mean to you. Sorry. Would you like to hear the secret? It's one of my pretends to be a princess. If I ever find myself wanting to be shot at someone, I try to be what a princess would say.
Funny. I try to think what you would say.
Oh, Becky, you're much kinder than I am. If I were in your shoes, I don't think I'd find it quite so easy to be kind.
If the tables were turned, you'd be scolded and fine, but you don't let it fall your day. I'd be going to class, pass the whistling glass, busy scrubbing the magic way. And you'd give me a frown.
£1,000. He can go to Mecca with it to send us his prayers. For £1,000, we will eat.
Is that it? Is that Timbuktu?
No. It is Jenny. A few hundred miles southwest.
Go home, Pasco. I am a dead man. I don't belong here, not in the interior. I should have never dragged you into this.
Please, Captain, let me sell this man the compass. You must not worry and get your strength back.
Eat it, he'll take this letter. Maybe it'll find its way back to Sara. If I never did.
Captain, no. Sara's compass is the only thing we have left. And you must eat.
I made a promise. I cannot.
Oh,
not the first girl to ever turn 13. But her birthdays are very different from ours.
No, no.
Her father once wrote me, I'm afraid Sarah must inherit a large fortune. What's a thing to be afraid about? I replied, her education will help her to spend it in a virtuous manner. Not knowing then that Sarah and her intrepid father would leave me to mine.
Our shares in the new Timbuktu Corporation have gone through the roof. I'm so pleased that we had the foresight to put in every penny we have.
Thank you, Miriam. I'm sure there's a thing. I hope you all appreciate Sarah's generosity in providing this afternoon's party.
Didn't we pay for it?
Shall we bring the children up to date on all of our financial affairs, sister? I'm expecting Sarah's grown father to repay us upon the school. Please say in unison, thank you, Sarah.
Thank you, Sarah.
Lavinia, the sounds you made sounded more like a snort. What did you mean to say?
Thank you, Sarah. When Miss mentioned the post-birthday party, I wanted her to make all of you as happy as I would be. And so, I had this box of presents ordered for all of us to share.
Miss Amelia, surely you're not expecting any callers.
Skipworth, who is he?
My father's solicitor.
If this were Thursday, sir, I would quite expect to see you. But as it isn't.
You want to meet with me privately, Miss Station?
Very well, then. Call me.
Rhinestones and paste tiaras. Really? Did you think we're all 7 years old?
Lavinia!
It's meant to be fun.
It's meant to make us big princesses like you. That's what Lottie says to our play out.
I'm sorry, Sarah. She pinned me and tickled me and came out of my mouth like magic.
So what if I'd like to play pretend, Lavinia? But how does it do you?
I'll show you how to be a princess.
You just smile when you love the ring and smile more or less. Then you walk like you chose to shove a stick up your chest. Since you feel the power to sleep.
Yeah.
dreams to bless the day. I love another world, but be it as it may, I fear this attic world may be the world where I shall.
Thank you.
that name.
But I have tried every girls' school in London.
Search the suburbs then for all I care. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm very busy.
Very pretty box then. It is from Africa, miss?
It was a gift. Change, see this person out.
Tippler. Winnie thinks I'm both.
Amelia, you forget.
will do her awful bidding for as many years as I have done.
How dare you say such a thing?
Oh no, not a goose, a camel. And the way you treat this poor girl is a straw that has broken my camel back. She has worked too hard, and that's all, and all you know it. How long do you intend to punish sorrow for the death of her father?
Amelia.
She's a clever child and a good child. Any kindness you show her would be amply repaid.
Have you forgotten whom you are addressing?
No, Winnie. I may have forgotten myself a moment, but I'll never forget you.
What?
Look in your heart. Isn't it true that you hate sorrow simply because she's the girl we wished ourselves to be once? Even without her advantages, her qualities remain.
Shall I go, miss?
You've embarrassed your little princess.
Once upon a time, I would pretend to be a princess. And pretty too.
I clear up, miss?
No, Sarah. I want you to join me.
Join you?
Yes. You must be starving. You have a future here. At some point, we all surrender the idea that a better one awaits.
What shall they be paying me?
What? Beg my pardon immediately.
Becky earns wages, miss. What shall I earn?
Do you know how much money you owe me?
No, I don't. How much did you get when you sold my things? How much am I earning now? Becky's no good at maths, but I am, and I know you don't pay her nearly what you promised.
What do you think of that?
What do you think my father would say to it?
You insolent, ungrateful child! How many careers do you think are open to the pauper child of a treasonous father? If you want to take Miss Amelia's place, you'll need to start by demonstrating a little more respect.
Take Miss Amelia's place? Sneer to me what you did to her?
Fine, up to the attic with you then. I don't have to pay you, I own you. If you won't work for me, I'll have a constable fetch you to the workhouse.
Go ahead, call a constable. There's no slavery in England.
No, but we don't coddle debtors here. You can either work off what you owe me or rot in a public institution. Go! Your luck has run out. Bad fortune, as it is. Having played a part in it, shouldn't I take heart in it? So I should, but damn it all, I do not feel I am at all. One shot more lucky. Lucky than
you'll never let them explore, you told me, Miss Sara.
You shan't have any dinner. Minchin sent me to bed early. We'll be locked in for the night.
We'll stay together, miss. For warmth. And then we won't be scared when it's dark.
You're afraid of the dark, are you? Do you believe in ghosts?
Not in the morning, but I do at night.
I knew a boy named Pasco. I thought I saw his ghost yesterday.
Oh, Miss Sara, speaking of ghosts and whatnot, I almost forgot your present.
Please stop calling me Miss Sara. I'm a servant now, same as you.
Right you are. I'll just call you Miss. Shall I? I gathered the bits and the girls all pitched into other bits. All but Lavinia.
If it were a bit thicker, we could burn it for a bit of heat.
Don't be like that, Miss Sara. Now we've got our jar back. The father's bound to follow. As long as you keep it nice, the spirit mother has to protect you. Right?
That's just a story, Becky. The truth is, if we stay here, we'll starve or freeze to death. And there's worse for a girl at the workhouse.
See, Miss Sara? There's always someone with the off. Oh, John, I've given you ideas already. You can make a story for that out of us. Something warming.
I can't tell a story on a night as cold as this when I've had no dinner. What's the matter now, Becky?
I'm trying to pretend I'm not fire for you.
That's not how you do it.
I give it my best.
Open your eyes. Don't shut them up tight.
But I have to keep them closed. Nothing here is the way it should be. I know you don't deserve this dirty room or dirty clothes. And I know I could think of something to make you feel better. If only I weren't so stupid.
Would you like to hear a story? It's about a doll that wants to be magical. Let's look. Nothing happens. Where's your magic now?
Magic brought us together, miss. There you were, in Africa. And I would have lived and died without a friend if magic can bring you here.
Well, I have none left.
But don't you know, won't stop here.
What's going on? dreaming?
I know I am, miss. Of a nice warm blanket and a fire.
But you're not dreaming! Where did this come from?
Zara, look!
Before. I thought Betty would be here by now.
I don't think the mission will let her.
go.
Minchin. And if she doesn't, we'll just have to go back for El Pasco.
I cannot let you. She would not make it easy to free you again.
Why are there so many constables here?
The Queen's carriage passes this way every morning. You must stay hidden. It's breakfast time. She's looking for a child to meet.
Oh, Pasco, don't believe everything I say. A carriage passes here?
Most nights I sleep under those bushes. Most mornings the carriage waits.
Pasco, you're a genius.
What did I say? Do you have a plan?
No, but I have a feeling. Queen Victoria was in my dream last night. Take me to those bushes.
Why wasn't nobody at the front door to greet me? Took her. Why not send her?
She has Becky on a leash.
Where's Miss Amelia then?
I heard she's in the hospital.
No. Did Becky say that too?
Becky said what when?
Just now. I'm passing out when she found the scene.
Technically, why do you ask? I suppose you mean Winifred.
You can't have
it. I couldn't believe it. They bore no resemblance to the man I once heard tell of his African adventures. And the little barefoot girl he loved so well. I have this for him.
It looks like a letter, Your Majesty, but it isn't sealed.
Read it then. I won't.
It's an apology! And a promotion! And all of his property restored!
We shall identify his detractors and deal with them. We have one problem, though. This letter does Major Groom no good here in London. Perhaps you wouldn't mind taking it to him. Though it may be too precious a document to entrust to a young girl alone, I was hoping I could